Hi, my name is Jim Heath. I'm the president of the Institute for Systems Biology, and I'm here today with Professor Sean Gibbons and Dr. Tomasz Wilmanski, who are the senior and lead authors, respectively, on a new exciting paper in Cell Met. So you guys hit upon a pretty important issue, which is statins, and who responds or who doesn't respond to statins, and what determines that response. So maybe you could explain a little bit about what you found.
So we really want to tackle the concept of statins, which are a cholesterol-lowering medication, and this heterogeneity where individuals who take the same exact drug have very different responses. Sometimes their LDL cholesterol decreases significantly, other times it's a minor response. And we looked at it from the perspective of the gut microbiome, so the trillions of bacteria living inside our gut. Previous studies have shown in vitro in experiments that bacteria in the gut are able to metabolize statins, but the clinical implications have not been explored. So our study really looks in a large human cohort of over 1,500 individuals, how your microbiome composition determines how you respond to statins.
So how do you get a database of 1,500 individuals?
Great question. So we, here at ISB, we actually work with a cohort from a now closed scientific wellness company, which recruited close to 3,500 individuals when it was active. And these individuals had their genome sequenced, their clinical lab measurements, a bunch of questionnaires. So it's a very rich resource for this kind of analysis.
So the fact that 1,500 of these patients, I guess, were either controls or on statins, that kind of tells you how important statins are, huh?
Yeah, absolutely. About 20% of adults in the U.S., 20 to 30% of adults in the U.S. are on statins currently.
Wow.
But would you like to add a little bit about the paper, Sean?
Sure. Yeah, I mean, it sort of changes how we think about precision medicine, personalized medicine. I mean, the Human Genome Project wrapped up, 22 years ago or so. And, you know, since then, you know, we thought we'd solve a lot of problems in precision medicine, right? We know the genome affects your responses to drugs, but that doesn't explain everything. There's a lot of variation that's unexplained. And so the microbiome, obviously, now we see is a mediator, it seems, of this kind of a response. So not only did we see a sort of effect on the on-target efficacy of the drug, right, bringing down LDL, but it seems to also affect your side effects. So the composition of the microbiome can mediate whether or not you have disrupted metabolism. Essentially, one of the big negative consequences of taking statins, they're not all good, right? They actually have a cost to them, right, is they can drive you towards prediabetes or type 2 diabetes, increases your insulin resistance. And we saw that some people with certain gut microbiome compositions were more likely to have this kind of a side effect.
And so is this because the microbiomes provide the enzymes, the bacteria provide the enzymes themselves that metabolize the drug, or they metabolize certain molecules that are associated with side effects? How, do you understand how that works?
You know, we don't quite understand the mechanism yet. As Tom alluded, you know, people have done in vitro work where they can show that bacteria can degrade statins. Whether or not those breakdown products of statins reduce the efficacy of the drug or maybe even turn it into kind of a pro-drug and make it more efficacious, right, these are things we don't quite yet understand. And we are trying now to build out work beyond this paper to do experiments in vitro in the lab where we can kind of cultivate microbes and with statins and look at these interactions directly and try to come up with what mechanistically is happening. But on the insulin resistance side of things, it's well known that microbes can mediate, you know, diabetes, metabolic syndrome. You know, certain bugs appear to be protective against this, and certain bugs appear to increase your risk, essentially. And so we think that there's an interesting interaction going on here, but we know there's an in vivo effect. We know that it's clinically relevant. We don't quite yet know how it happens, I guess, at this point.
So there's two, I guess, obvious outcomes of this. One is that you, by understanding the patient's microbiome, you can anticipate what's going to happen when you treat them with statins to some extent. And the other is that you might think about either tailoring the microbiome or tailoring the statins or the statin dose or something like that, so that they sync up in a way that is most beneficial for the patient. Is that, do I have that right?
Oh, totally. I mean, yeah, we've thought about that quite a bit. Tom, do you want to give a summary of kind of our thinking there?
I think one very interesting finding from the study relating to your point is that we had genetic information on these individuals, and right. Genetics are increasingly involved in the clinic where people with certain genetic predisposition, we know how they're going to respond to a drug, and we can cater the drug based on your genetic footprint.
Right.
The microbiome in many cases seems to be independent of your genetic risk. It's a different axis of variability among right. individuals. So we were able to build models including both genetics and the gut microbiome, and as you increase the data you collect on an individual, you're getting a more comprehensive picture of how they're going to respond to statins. So the way we think this might move forward is a clinician has your genetic information, but also has your microbiome information. And in some digestible way, all of this can be united in how they prescribe medications to you.
And so let's say you have a patient that really needs statins, would you think about tuning their microbiome, changing their diet or something like that? Is that a possibility?
Yeah, and I think it's a bit different from the study we looked in particular, but the microbiome is impacted by diet and lifestyle, of course, but it definitely contributes to both lipid metabolism, glucose homeostasis.
Right.
And oftentimes individuals on statins are also encouraged to change their lifestyle, to improve their cholesterol without the need of medication.
Right.
The interaction of the gut microbiome in all of this still remains to be understood.
So what's next for you guys?
So yeah, what's next? And also kind of to add on to Tom's point before, you know, the signatures we see in the microbiome tell us something about what's going on. Right? We see that people who have an enrichment in a particular bug, a group of bugs called Bacteroides, seems to be at higher risk for side effects. And they would probably benefit from a lower dose statin. So you could imagine providing clinicians with this information and improving the standard of care, essentially, for how statins are given out to people. We also see certain taxa that when they're missing from a person's gut, they seem to have an adverse effect on metabolism. One of these bugs was called Akkermansia mucinophila. And this organism just happens to have recently been approved as a probiotic that can be taken by humans. A company called Pendulum now provides this probiotic. So you could also imagine manipulating someone's microbiome to take them from a high risk of metabolic disruption from statin to lower that risk by adding a probiotic like Akkermansia to supplement their microbiome. But ultimately, you know, where we want to go after this is proving that it can work in humans. I mean, a clinical trial would be great to show that you can take this information on the genome and on the microbiome, predict a sort of dosing regimen for a given patient, and then follow those patients forward in time and track their metabolic health and their LDL cholesterol, and show that a population of patients with this precision intervention based on their genome and their microbiome do better as a whole than like a group of standard of care patients who just get what normally is given to them.
Awesome. That sounds like a study that patients would be excited to participate in. Benefits are so obvious. Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool. Well, thank you guys.
Thank you.